was a huge help here. She was the one that reached out and got Dinsmore involved.
I came in and worked on the project, starting with getting a scan of his foot. We used that scan as a reference that we created the boot around. So I used it to model his boot, and we even were able to here at Decker's print in-house, but that became limited on the durability of the printer we have. It's a prototype printer. And that was sort of where I got stuck and reached out to Dinsmore to come in and help us create a stronger, more durable boot that Lucky can wear.
Building the boot in a material that can be used for actual function and last a lot longer. And Lucky's still wearing the boot, and it has not failed yet. So I'd say that's a great success. So we're behind the scenes of the Humboldt Penguin exhibit here. And what we're looking at is two different versions of 3D printed boots that were built for Lucky. And maybe you can explain to us what happened with this first version here, and let us know what happened with the one that Dinsmore built for you.
Yeah, definitely. So this is our first attempt at a soft boot for Lucky to wear during molt, since he swells and doesn't fit in his regular size shoes anymore. And this one, we had some weak spots. The material was definitely not as resilient as we needed it to be. The strap adjustments started to kind of come out.
So this first version was done in PolyJet, which PolyJet is a great way of 3D printing. However, more for proof of concept and has its limitations on function. Whereas we built these boots in both Carbon's DLS technology, and we made a soft tool using RTV molding process to give a casting in a urethane material. And it looks like what we provided worked great.
One of the best things about Lucky having these boots and being with us for as long as he have is that he's been able to pair up and pick a mate and reproduce. So we have Pepper, his offspring, in the exhibit here. And he's a very valuable member of not only the colony, but our Humboldt penguin population in captivity. Lucky is very genetically valuable, and having his genes contribute to our population so it can remain healthy and sustainable is very important to us.